Now in section 3.4.2, we will consider the monopole in the dipole terms. As we have already done the multipole expansion, and in the multipole expansion, we got the first term is the monopole term, the second term is the dipole term, and then the third is the quadrupole, and fourth is the octupole, and so on. So the two terms, they are very important from the point of view that sometime we discuss the distance, that is r, which is what will happen at long distances when r goes to infinity. When we move much far away from the charge distribution, and then the other term is what about if q goes to zero, when the source charge goes to zero, or when the charge distribution goes to zero, then what will happen? So let me discuss these, the monopole and the dipole terms, in detail. And in this one, we will introduce the term which I discussed earlier with you, the dipole moment term. So here we are having the equation for the monopole term V of R. This is monopole term, and this is 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught and Q over R. And the dipole term V of R, dipole, and the dipole term is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught 1 over r squared and r prime cos theta prime rho of r prime in d tau prime. So in this form we have achieved this in the multipole expansion. Now here there are basically two things here, as I discussed. Now, the very first one, when r goes to infinity, in case when r goes to infinity, then in the multipole expansion, this one is the dominant term, because the monopole term is the dominant, monopole term is dominant, and it is dominant in the sense that it is decaying very slowly, while at large distances these are decaying very fast. So they are decaying very fast, and monopole term decays slowly, so that's why this one is the dominant term. And when we consider the situation in which Q goes to zero, means the charge distribution goes to zero, then we are having the dipole term is the dominant term. And the reason for this one, that when Q goes to zero, then this one is Q dependent and it goes to zero, so the monopole term doesn't exist anymore. While then the next term is this one, and this is the next term which is decaying slowly compared to this one, okay, because it is closer to this one, it is r squared. The rest of the terms are vanishing at large distances, so the next term which will comparatively decay slow to the monopole term is this term. And in that one we see that this will be the next dominant term. When q equal to zero, q goes to zero, the monopole term vanishes very quickly because it is wholly solely dependent on q equal means on q. So this goes to zero and it goes there. So these two terms are very important, and we are discussing these two terms here. Now if I look at the term which is the dipole term, then this term which is the r prime cos theta, I can write this term is the r prime cos theta prime can be written as r unit vector is a dot product with r prime as a vector. Now what will happen? That this will become r unit vector magnitude is 1, so we have r prime and the angle between is we have the figure in the earlier lecture. This the angle between these two was equal to theta prime, so this will be r prime r cos prime cos theta prime. So I can write the dipole term is v of r equals 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught and 1 over r squared, and here I write r unit vector dot in the integral. Here I write r prime is vector and rho of r prime and d tau prime. So this one, you know the term which is here, you remember that the term which is here and this one r, this is rho and d tau. This is basically giving us the total charge here. So this is the charge, and this is the distance which is multiplied with this one. And this r prime, what is r prime? In the figure, you know that r prime was the distance from the point to the source. So it means it is the fixed distance that we have. And in the earlier lecture, we considered this is equal to d. And in the next, we consider it is r prime. So this is basically charge time distance. And the charge time distance, we have earlier said that this is basically the dipole moment and it is inside the source. So I can write that this P, I define this P is equal, this P, which is a vector quantity, and this is equal to r prime and rho of r prime and d tau prime. So this is called is the dipole moment. Dipole moment, it's a vector quantity and it is composed of the two things, the charge and the distance between the charges. So we will have to differentiate here between two things. One is a physical dipole and the other is the point dipole. So we will have to differentiate between the two things. The point dipole, which we call the real dipole, and the other is a physical dipole. A physical dipole and a pure dipole. So these are the two terminologies which we will discuss in a while. A physical dipole or a point dipole, or we call is pure dipole. Pure dipole means that we are having two point charges which are separated a distance d. Then the P, the dipole moment, is equal to q times d, means that qd are in scalar form. I can write this is p equal qd. While a physical dipole, it's the charges in some distance we as we observed in the previous figure, where we were having an irregular shape of charge distribution. So let me first discuss this one, the dipole moment. I write the dipole terms in the terms of dipole moment, and then we will come to the physical and the pure dipole or the point dipole. So this thing I can write then that V of R of a dipole can be written is 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught and P dot R unit vector over R squared. So this is the dipole, the potential due to a dipole in the form of dipole moment. And as usual, we write the dipole moment P is equal to summation on N, and let me write it, summation on I or summation on N is the same thing, summation on N running from 1 up to, better we write this from I runs from 1 to N, because here if I write N runs from 1, so it will become confusing. So I runs from 1 up to N and Q I R I. Now Q I and R I, and we write the prime with this one. So this is basically the same thing that Q times D, and then it will be, if I do for example for physical dipole means equal in opposite charges separated at a certain distance, then this will be equal to, like here if I expand this one, then it will come out to be Q, and Q with a plus, okay, Q is a plus, and then R is plus and prime, and then minus Q, and R is minus prime. So Q is the same here, and we are having R plus prime minus R minus prime, and this thing is equal to D. So finally we got that result back, and this is the dipole moment. And so here is a comment that a physical dipole becomes a pure dipole in a rather, you can say, artificial situation when D goes to zero, like the separation between the charges is going to zero and Q goes to infinity. Like we are making the charges bigger and bigger and their distance is decreasing. So this is the means the physical dipole converting into a pure dipole. Pure dipole we call is like a point dipole, just like a point. Any point means when the distance is so small and the charges are big enough, we call it is a point dipole. And if we consider the octupole, the quadrupole situation, then in the quadrupole the dipole moment is zero. Even if we consider the dipole moment along the vertical or we consider along the horizontal, then the dipole moment in all that situation will add up, and it will add up to zero.